السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير، واشهد ان محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله واصحابه ومن تبعهم باحسان الى يوم الدين. فان اصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله، وشر الامور محدثاتها وكل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار. ايها المسلمون، اعلموا ان الجنه حق وان النار حق وان الله يبعث من في القبور. اما بعد، يقول الله تعالى في القران الكريم بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. My dear brothers and sisters, I began by saying all praises, all gratitude and all thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we seek refuge from Allah from the sin that we commit and the faults within ourselves. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves astray, no one can guide. We bear witness that no deity worthy to worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we bear witness to the Prophet Muhammad alayhi afdal as-salatu wassalam, his final and his last message. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless the Prophet Muhammad and his family and his companion, and whoever follow him until the judgment day, Allahu Ameen. I shared with you from one verse from Surah Al-Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us who you believe. Fear Allah and should be feared and die not until this God in the state of Islam. So my dear brother and sister, we're going to be talking about the legacy of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, and also of course Dhul Hijjah and Yawm Arafah. When I was preparing this khutbah, I knew Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, very important prophet. And I knew about Dhul Hijjah is important. But when I finished my research and reading, I found out it's not just important, it's extremely important. Very, very, very important. So I do hope and pray you will benefit, inshallah, from today's khutbah. My dear brother and sister, I would like to bring your attention. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, we mention his name every time we pray 4 times in every prayer. And if we pray 5 times a day, 4 times 5, that's 20 times. If you just pray your regular prayer 5 times, you are repeating his name minimum of 20 times. And his name has been mentioned in the Holy Quran at least 69 times. 69 times. And there is a surah number 14, which is about Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. And Prophet Ismail, by the way, also his name is mentioned 12 times. Prophet Ibrahim, my dear brother and sister, was born in the modern day, the country Iraq. And the time when he was born, most of the people, they are worshiping the sun, idols, moons, stars, anything that they can create and do it themselves, and then they worship it. It's pathetic. I don't understand. Every time I say that, or I think about that, where is the brain? Where is the common sense that you make an idol for yourself and you worship it? How in the world they are doing this? And my dear brother and sister, his father, he was in that business. And his father, Prophet Ibrahim, his name is Azar. Of course, he was Kafir, pagan, does not understand any better. And when Ibrahim alayhi salam, he grew up, he started thinking, what is going on with my dad? He's making this idol and he's pushing me to sell it in the market, and he's selling it in the market. Something is wrong. We need to stop that. So he approached his dad one day and he told him that we have a dialogue between him and his father, and I'm going to share that with you from Surah Maryam. By the Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. إذ قال لأبيه يا أبت لم تعبد ما لا يسمع ولا يبصر ولا يبصر ولا يغني عنك شيئا. He said, when he, my dear father, why do you worship something that neither hear or near or see or help you in any way or shape? And he continued advising his father with a nice, polite way. Ya abati, inni qad ja'ani min al-'ilm ma lam ya'tika fattabi'ni. Fattabi'ni ahdika siratan sawiyya. My dear father, indeed there has come to me a knowledge that has not come to you. So follow me, and I shall lead you to the straight path. And he continued advising his father. Ya abati la ta'bud ash-shaytan. Inna ash-shaytana kana lir-rahman 'asiya. Oh my dear father, do not worship the shaytan. Shaytan was rebellious against Allah. He's the most gracious. And he did not stop there. Ya abati, إني أخاف أن يمسك عذاب من الرحمن فتكون للشيطان وليا. Oh my dear father, I fear for you. I fear for you, you will be afflicted from Allah, the most gracious, the one you will be a friend of the shaitan. Now the father is now, he's going to respond to his son. And look what he's saying. قال أراغب أنت عن آلهتي يا إبراهيم لئن لم تنتهي لأرجمنك واهجرني مليا. Now the father is threatening his son. And what did he say? The father said, do you reject my gods, O Ibrahim? If you do not stop, I will stone you. I will stone you. So get away from me safely before I punish you. Now, look at the threat, my dear brother and sister, of the father to his own, to his son. And now, when he tell him, I'm going to stone you, do we understand what he means stone you? A long time ago, they used, when they want to kill someone, and then they tie him to a tree. And then a bunch of people comes in with stones, and they stone him until he died. The most brutal way that you could kill someone. Very slow way. And now look at how polite Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. And then he responds to his father. He doesn't respond harsh. What did he say? قَالَ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكَ سَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكَ رَبِّي إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِي حَفِيًّا. Ibrahim said, peace be on you. I will seek forgiveness from my Lord. He's always been gracious to me. So you see how powerful the statement and how polite Prophet Ibrahim, my dear brother and sister. So Prophet Ibrahim, he understood there's no way he's going to help his father, and he gave up, he surrendered. So one day, these pagans, they have a festival, and they invited everyone in town, and Ibrahim, he refused to go there and celebrate with them. And he decided to go to the temple, and then to destroy their idols and their statues. And he damaged them all, and he put the axe on the largest one. Hopefully, they can comprehend and understand. Talk with them. See who will tell you who did it. So they, after this, they came back to the temple. They found all the statues are damaged except one. And then they talked among each other, and then they said, there is a person, his name is Ibrahim, and he does not like our statue, the way we worshiping our gods, so let us have him. And then of course they found him and they got him and they find him out. And they put a huge flame, big flame that even a bird flying above, it will drop down and die. Everyone participated and they put him in a big sling because the heat is so much they cannot even come close to the fire. And they put him in the sling and they let it go, and he got to the fire. So when he was going to the fire, what did he say? Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. This is what he said when he was going to the fire. Allah is enough for me, and he is the best disposer of affairs. So my dear brother and sister, look at what happened here. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately ordered the fire, and he said the following, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِ بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the fire to be safe and calm, and not too cold and not too hot for Ibrahim. Ibrahim, he came out, alayhi salam, out of the fire, smiling, and nothing injured him, and everyone was so surprised and wondering how in this happened. He comes out of the fire, smiling, and nothing happened to him. So my dear brother and sister, years passed, and then Prophet Ibrahim, alayhi salam, he married Sarah. And then it stayed a few years, and she did not have any children. And then Sarah, she understood that there's no way she's going to have a child for Prophet Ibrahim. And then she asked him, he can marry Hagar, which is their worker at home, their helper, the Egyptian lady. And then they decide to marry Hagar. So brother and sister, years passed, and then what happened after this? They are, Prophet Ibrahim was ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take Hajar and Ismail and to leave them between two mountains, which is Safa and Marwa. And then when he left it there, she calling on him and she's telling him, why are you leaving us here in the desert? And back and forth, finally she understood that this is the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then she understood she is in a safe place. She's under Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's control. And then she ran out of water, ran out of food, and now her baby is crying, what she knew. She started going between Safa and Marwa 7 times. And this is what the Hajjaj is doing today, my dear brother and sister. She's looking for water. Finally, she found the water. Mount Zamzam rushing out of the ground. Years passed. I'm going fast because, of course, you know, this story is very, very long and we have a limited amount of time. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Prophet Ibrahim and Ismail to build the first place, and they built the first place in Mecca, which is Dakar. And I would like to share that with you from Surah Al-Imran by the Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna awwala baytin wud'a lin-nas lalladhi bi-Bakkata mubarakan wa hudan lil-'alamin. Indeed, the first house to worship and establish for mankind in Bi-Bakkah. Bakkah, which is Mecca. It used to be called Bakkah a long time ago, but now we call it Mecca. فيه آيات بينات مقام إبراهيم ومن دخله كان آمنا ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا ومن كفر فإن الله غني عن العالمين. In it, a clear sign such as the Maqam Ibrahim, and whoever entered shall have a safe place there, and the people must perform Hajj if you are able to. It's an obligation, my dear brother and sister, to do Hajj. Now, after it has been built, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Prophet Ibrahim to call upon us, to call upon people to come and to do Hajj. He responded, Ya Allah, at that time, of course, we had no microphone, we had no loudspeakers, we had no internet, none of that stuff exists. Ya Allah, how can I call and nobody will hear me? And he responded, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you do the call and we will make sure everyone, including the infant in the mother's womb, will hear your call. Look at today, my dear brother and sister. Look at today. How many of us, we hear the adhan and we go there, inshallah, alhamdulillah. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيمٍ. And announce among the people for Hajj, and they will should come to you on foot, and every camel traveling through, and every distant hilly and pathway. A lot of us are found when we hear rijalan. Some of us, brother and sister, we translate it like it's men, but actually it's not men. Rijalan means coming on foot, coming to you. And sure enough, a lot of people, they go to Kaaba to do Hajj on foot, and camels and airplanes and ships everywhere. لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْبَائِسَ الْفَقِيرَ. So the witness benefit from them and recite Allah's name in a specific days, my dear brother and sister. And then we go there and we say what? لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ لَبَّيْكَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَكَ لَبَّيْكَ إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ وَالنَّعْمَةَ لَكَ وَالْمُلْكَ. What is the word لَبَّيْكَ? Have you thought about it, my dear brother and sister? It means we are obedient, Ya Allah. We are responding to your call. We are here, Ya Allah. And then, of course, also we say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Brother and sister, we need to understand the meaning and the weight of the word Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, my dear brother and sister, it means Allah is greater than anything that you can visualize, imagine, and more powerful, and more majestic, and more magnificent than anything that you can visualize. That's how much this weight, the word weight, Allahu Akbar, is huge. So my dear brother and sister, we, every one of us, if you are capable to do Hajj, and you are financially capable, and health-wise, you must go and perform Hajj. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إن الله غفور رحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وخاتم الأنبياء سيدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله. My dear brother and sister, we are in the month of Dhul-Hijjah. And Dhul-Hijjah is the last month of the lunar calendar. And last Monday, my dear brother and sister, last Monday, it was the first day of the Dhul-Hijjah. And Tuesday, inshallah, Tuesday, June 27, it will be Yom Arafah. It's a very, very, very important day. And Wednesday, June 28, inshallah, the Eid, Eid al-Adha al-Mubarak. I would like to wish you all a very happy and blessed Eid al-Adha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our siyam, our qiyam, our salah, and every way that we worship Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Allahumma ameen. My dear brother and sister, most scholars, they agree that the best 10 days of the whole year, is the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. There is no ifs or buts about that. They all agree on that. And the best day of those 10 days is Yawm Arafah. Take Yawm Arafah extremely, extremely, extremely serious. If your destination is Jannah al-Firdaws al-A'la, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He pardoned a lot of people, my dear brother and sister, on that day, Yawm Arafah, more than any other day. So it is your golden opportunity to take this day extremely, extremely serious. It's highly recommended that you fast all those 10 days, but if you can't, try to fast Yawm Arafah, which is Tuesday, June the 27th. And my dear brother and sister, Yawm Arafah is ma'roof. It's different than Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr, my dear brother and sister, we're speculating in the last 10 days. There is no speculation when you come to Yawm Arafah. You have no excuse to do what you need to do to please Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Al-Wahid Al-Ahad Allah. It's very, very important. And you do massive dua. And let me tell you the best dua that Yawm Arafah, which Allah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us to do. And he said the prophets before him used to do the following, and I'm going to share that with you. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Wahdahu la sharika lah. Lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamd. Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to say this dua, and he stated the prophets before him, they used to say that. What does this dua mean? There is no God but Allah, and he has no partner, and he has dominion over everything, and all praise is due to him. My dear brother and sister, also, I would like to bring your attention, the best 10 nights of the whole nights, before we say days, now we say nights, the best 10 nights of the whole year, of course, the last 10 days of Ramadan. And the best night of Ramadan, of course, Laylatul Qadr, the night of power. So do your best, my dear brother and sister. So what we should do in whatever days that we have left right now, what we should do, what is our responsibility in the event your destination is Al-Firdaws al-A'la? Number one, try to fast as much as you can. If your health allows you, please try to fast. And then perform, of course, Hajj next year, or plan to do Hajj. If you are financially capable and healthy, then it becomes an obligation on you as Muslim. You cannot. You say, I will do everything else, but when it comes to Hajj, count me out, and you are physically capable and financially capable. You become, it's an obligation. And also, brother and sister, do tons of istighfar through the day, from now until the end, especially Yawm Arafah. And then also read more Quran. Read more Quran and try to understand what you are reading. And then also pray more prayer than what you normally do. And then give charity. Give charity, sadaqa jariyah. Start with your own masjid. Wallahi, wallahi, wallahi. This is no better time than today, Yawm al-Jum'ah, and you are in the last 10 days, is to get your masjid. ما شاء الله ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Every single time I come and visit you, I see a major changes, not just changes, major changes. These changes, my dear brother and sister, it doesn't happen by itself. It happened because of righteous brother and sister like each one of you. You have put your hand together when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَقْتَصَمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. You took it literally and you're doing a great job. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless and reward each one of you for putting on your dollar, on your time, on your dua, on a brick in this masjid. Say that me. My dear brother and sister, continue takbirat every single day. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيه أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام. Again, ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيه أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام. يعني أيام العشر. And then رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, ولا الجهاد, ولا he said, يا رسول الله ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله. He said, ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ولم يرجع بشيء. So my dear brother and sister, it's very, very serious that you do your best to please Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Wahid, Al-Ahad in these days. And do what you can because it's very, very important. Wallahi, the more you read about it, you will understand Yawm Arafah. It's a serious day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us. And also do a lot of repentance. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us, كل ابن آدم خطاء خير الخطائين التوابون. So repent through today and tomorrow and every day. And let me share with you from Surah Al-Hajj, بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he addressed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, tell my servant, نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم, I am the most merciful. And also in the same topic, أن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. So do your best to please Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And also, I'd like to share before we close. بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Oh, tell my servant of mine that he acted recklessly against their own self. Their own self. Do not despair the mercy of Allah. Allah will forgive all sin. Doesn't matter what you have done. And also remember, you need to sacrifice an animal. Follow Prophet Ibrahim and Prophet Ismail and sacrifice an animal. If you cannot afford it by yourself, you can join a group of people. You put $100, $50, $10, whatever your financial allow you, but try to participate in this. Allahumma taqabbal min rabbil alameen. Before I close, my dear brother and sister, I have a dear friend, his grandson, in a serious, serious situation, ICU, and he asked me, his name is Muhammad Arshad, and the boy, his name is Dean Adam. And he's in a critical situation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him a speedy recovery. Say ameen. Allahumma give him a speedy recovery. Allahumma ameen. Inna Allahumma la'ayni salun ala nabihi ya ayuhal ladina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Kama sallayt ala Sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali Sayyidina Ibrahim fil alameen naka ameenil majeed. Wa khala rabbukum id'uni astajib lakum. Allahumma barik lana fi ayyam al-dunya al-ashr. من ذو الحجة وأعنا فيها على الصيام والقيام واجعل لنا دعوة لا تراد ورزقا لا يعد ومغفرة وعفو منك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم بلغنا يوم عرفة وتقبله منا. اللهم بلغنا عيد الأضحى المبارك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اعف عنا وعن آبائنا وأمهاتنا من عذاب النار. يا منزل الماء من السماء، يا مخرج النبات من الأرض، يا من قلت للنار كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم، اعف عنا وارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا، وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. رحمن يا رحيم العفو والرضا منك، وادخلنا الفردوس الاعلى بغير حساب، ادخلنا الفردوس الاعلى بغير حساب. عباد الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم. Before I say after salah, right after salah, I'm going to talk a little bit about your masjid and your needs. And please remain seated for just a couple of minutes. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
إياك نعبد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
My dear brother and sister, السلام الله عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I'd like to congratulate each one of you for a job well done in your mission. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from you and put it in your deeds, the scale of deeds, yes. Okay, we have Brother Kawi here. He's going to do a couple of announcements and then I will share with you about your mission, what your mission is, inshallah.
Just I'll try to be very quick. Salat al-Eid is Wednesday morning at 7 o'clock is the first salah, the second salah is at 7:40. Day of Arafah. That night, Tuesday night, we're going to have iftar, inshallah, and we're going to have some activities. On Eid day, we're going to have jumpers and toys for kids and breakfast, inshallah. So we'll see you all, inshallah. We will have our Friday night program with Brother Jahombo tonight. Quran class is still at 5:15 for the kids. Sunday program is still there. And we've learned so much. I myself have learned so much from the Tajweed class on Saturday morning. So if anybody is really interested and serious about learning how to improve their Tajweed, please make it after Fajr on Saturday morning. Jazakallah.
My dear brother and sister, you see the progress of your mission. It speaks louder than words. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, we are moving very, very fast, and we are moving as fast as you are donating. So today, there could not be any better day than giving to Sabilillah. Is anyone among you here could afford to spend the fi sabilillah yawm al-jum'ah in Dhul Hijjah, which is very, very blessed day and days, $5,000, and I'm going to do a massive du'a for you, inshallah, and everyone will say after me, Ameen. Who is the lucky person who will start, inshallah, $5,000? We need your help and support, inshallah. Who could do it? I'm looking for $5,000, inshallah. Anyone, I'm not going to take too long. Any one of you, how about this? I will donate $5,000, but on a condition that we can have at least five people to match each one of you, 1,000. So how many of you could match, inshallah? Only $1,000, and I'm going to put $5,000 as a condition that I can raise another $5,000 right now. Who's going to be the lucky one? Number one. Where is number one, inshallah? Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, Takbir. We have a sister, she's waiting in the back. A sister waiting in the back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. We yaktub laki al-jannah, please let her hear the word Ameen. Ameen. Who's going to follow that sister, inshallah? $1,000. We say $1,000. We're not saying $5,000. $1,000, inshallah. Where is the brother? Oh man, the brother, Dr. Muhammad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you for everything you have done from day one. Say Ameen. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put you ma'as-siddiqin as-salihin. Allahumma ameen. Okay, now who's going to follow Dr. Muhammad here, inshallah? Where? Oh, Allah. 3,000? Allahu Akbar. Takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. وَيَكْتُبْ لَكَ الْجَنَّةِ. Please, we can hear Ameen. Allahumma ameen. So who's going to follow? We are talking about 1,000. I was asking for 1,000, and the generous brother, he said, no, I'm going to give 3,000. Look at how beautiful it is. Wallahi, there is no better time and day than today to donate fi sabilillah and donate fi sabilillah. Allahu Akbar, Takbir. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. The brother asking for 1,000, he said, no, not 3, not 2. And he said, 5,000. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and protect you. We yaktub laka al-jannah, you and everyone you love. Please, let him hear the word Ameen. Say it loud and clearly. Ameen. Allahumma taqabbal minna, brother. Allahumma ameen. Who's going to follow? By any amount, I'm talking about 1,000, inshallah. Do not be excluded from today. Wallahi, you're going to need it in the judgment day. So how about this? How about $500? Anyone can afford $500, inshallah. And I'm going to do dua for you as well. $500, inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahu Akbar. 500? Allahu Akbar. Takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you and protect you. My brother and sister, wallahi, your mission needs it. And the thing is that you see what is going on a daily basis. There's improvement. Every time I come, I see something major has taken place. So who, anyone here, inshallah, $500? And the sisters in the back there, $500? And we're going to do dua for you, inshallah. Anyone, $500. Okay, how about anyone? $500. Okay, how about $200? Anyone before I close? $200. Where? Oh, how much? $200. Allahu Akbar. Takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and protect you. Allahumma ameen. $200. Anyone? Allah, how much? $300. Allahu Akbar. Takbir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and protect you. Yaktub laka al-jannah, $300. Anyone else, inshallah? My dear brother and sister, wallahi, we need it yawm al-hisab. You're going to see it, inshallah, in your scale of good deeds. You're going to need it, and there is no better time. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, there is no better time than those 10 days we are living in. So anyone, before I close, 100, 200, any amount, and I'll do a massive dua for you. Anyone? Anyone? I would like to close with something. Okay, where? Arfa, go ahead and raise your hand again. Where? Oh, okay. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Anyone before I say salamu alaykum?
Anyone last dua? Who would like to take last dua for any amount? Even $50 or $100, inshallah. Dua for $50 or $100? 300, Allahu Akbar. Thank you, doctor. May Allah, $300 dua here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and your Lord and protect you. We yaktub laka jannah for everything you have done for us here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you and protect your family. Please say it so loud. Ameen. Allahu taqabbal. Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.